You've seen how arrays can store a sequence of values, such as this one. Here we have three prices for three different kinds of gasoline. Well, what if you have two gas stations? In this case, you will want to store a two-dimensional arrangement with rows and columns. Two-dimensional arrays can do that. In this example, we would have three rows and two columns. In Java, we get such an arrangement by saying, give me a new array of doubles, of floating point numbers, and I want three rows, two columns. In general, the first number is the number of rows, the second one, the number of columns. Note the type, it's a double brackets brackets, meaning it's a two-dimensional array of numbers. If you already know which numbers should go into the two-dimensional array, then you can supply them like this. Again, here I have a two-dimensional array of prices, and now you put a pair of braces for the entire array, and then for each row, you put another pair of braces with the values. So here we have three rows, each of which is enclosed in a pair of braces. Now you know how to declare a two-dimensional array. Next, let's have a look at how we can access its elements.